We live in an age of constant change. All you have to do is wait till tomorrow and the world's going to be different. It's going so fast that some of us Medicare age guys, we struggle because you wake up the next morning and you got new gadgets. You should have seen me trying to sign up for Medicare. Right? You just fill out a form and send it in. You got to go online. You got to do this. You got to do that. The world's changing rapidly. But you know what hasn't changed? Is Kent and Ravenna are going to get together on the football team. That hasn't changed. I think there's something great about that. Secondly, our two communities share a common heritage and history. Many families can trace their roots to both communities, making this really a family affair. I think the one thing that was so touching to me as the principal of Roosevelt High School was it didn't matter the outcome of the game to see people decked out in blue and decked out in red coming together, hugging, crying sometimes, sometimes celebrating together, sometimes poking fun at one another in a good-natured way because they had won or someone had lost and those type of things. That to me is real significant. I want you young people to understand it doesn't happen in all communities this way. It doesn't happen. This thing is bigger than all of us. It's bigger than the two communities. It's about something that is pretty magical in my mind. Beyond the family connections and the business and commercial interests of both communities are so intertwined, you know, as well as the residents of communities working in the various the different communities, we're all vying for bragging rights, but for some reason, it works, and it works well. We have a wonderful newspaper that continues, if you watch the series that was in there about the series, that doesn't happen everywhere, but it does happen in Kent and Ravenna. I think that's important. So, I believe that this historical game really kind of establishes a standard of excellence that young people can learn from, our players can learn from, and I think our players can help teach the community at large. When I was a principal at Kent, we couldn't always objectively explain how we did things at Roosevelt and the nuances of our school community. And we adopted something that we called the Roosevelt way. There were certain things we couldn't explain, it was just the Roosevelt way of doing things. You know, I believe that this game has established a standard in defining a healthy relationship between the two communities. I call it the Ravenna Kent way. This is unique. And I'm going to emphasize this again to the young people in the audience. This is unique. I want to echo what some people have said before me. Remember Friday night. It doesn't happen this way in all communities. Remember that feeling that you have when you're out there in the field. It's a noble rivalry. Noble is an old word, but what it really connotes is that there's a connotation to it, that there's a deep and mutually abiding respect for each other. There's a deep and abiding and mutual respect for what we each stand for. There's a deep and abiding respect for what the future is going to hold for all of us. Both teams want to win, but I don't think either team wants to humiliate or defeat the opponent. What they want to do is they want to put their best on the field against the best in their neighbors. And isn't that what it should be all about?